This beautiful morning, just birds singing. I want to talk about a dog that is a low-key type of guard dog. Some people want a dog that is assumed to be friendly, has no negative connotations at all, is quite capable of being a watchdog and has a small potential, if the case should arise, to also be a little bit of a guard dog. Then they ask me, what dog could do that in a low key way? Then I gave them multiple options, for example, a hoverwart. And then they say, yeah, but the coat is too long, I don't like that. I give them the option of a Rhodesian Ridgeback, and they say, no, it's too big and too intimidating a dog, even though it doesn't have that much negative connotations. And also some people, when I tell them about, for example, a Weimaraner, they also say, okay, this dog is everything that I wanted, but not my taste, because I don't like this gray color. I like something more different color with different markings. Okay. And then when he asks them what they want a dog that has spots or has some black markings. So I told them about the Dalmatian. The Dalmatian is developed in the eastern part of Europe. It was developed as a dog to accompany the horse and carriage accommodations of the rich. And was a dog that was also able to defend stables, where they kept the horses and the houses of their masters. So that gives you some insight about the dog that's most associated with 101 Dalmatians in movies. So it gives you that kind of Disney vibe that those people really like. This dog that you see here is also a very nice choice to make, but for some people it's a little bit hyper, and also they want a bigger dog. This is just a small dog. It's an Ur Terrier, a black fell terrier, also known as the Platterdill. Also, it cannot never be making the impact of a big dog like a Dalmatian can, of course. So back to the Dalmatian, it's a dog that is because accompanied the horse and carriage, and also sometimes the horse trips. It's a fast dog, which means it is quite athletic. Also, it's a dog that has guarding instinct, so that makes it a dog that next to its Disney vibe and low-key appearance can be a good protector of your terrain or even your house. And even if it has to make some big rounds to check the perimeters, this is quite an active type of dog. It's not hyperactive in that way that it's like a Jack Russell is or something like that. It also it is not a dog that has that really vicious streak. Of course not. It is an alert type of watchdog. It is a plus. Also, the bark is reasonably loud. That's also nice if you want to have a watch type of dog that can also alert you when something is amiss. And it's quite a nice companion. In the past, when those movies came out, 101 Dalmatian, but also 1001 Dalmatian, I think, there was a run on this type of dogs. And the popularity also again improved when it came out on the video. That were those times. And those initiated a lot of breeders to breed wrong type of Dalmatians. Also, nowadays they have rebreeding dilutions of the Dalmatian. For example, if you inbreed a lot, or you get otherwise dilutions of colors, then for example you don't have a white dog with black markings, but you get white dogs with brownish markings. And that brown is a dilution of black in this case. So keep that in mind. It can appear very nice, but oftentimes dilutions also mean that other genes can be mutated to work less properly, because that's the case. The coloration is working less properly than those with the black dot. And as I mentioned, because a lot of Dalmatians once were bred, because the popularity rise gave away a lot of shitty breedings, very much inbreeding, just getting as much of dog over the table as possible, instead of a real stable kind of dogs that were also very healthy. So this is a point of attention. Another point of attention is that especially dogs that are predominantly white can often become or are deaf. There's a test that you can perform. It's called the BAER or BEAR test, which is a hearing test, and they check both ears and how much they can hear. Goedemorgen. Zo wat die. Zo mooi, hè? Echt je kameraadje, hè?
Ja. Zo.
Oh jee. Oh jee. Lekker spelen toch?
Ja, leuk.
Ik denk als ik hem niet loslaat dat het zo blijft gaan. Wij kunnen niet sneller losmaken dan dat zij weer vastzetten, zie je? Ja. Nou, het had ook bijna zijn al van los gegooid. Heel leuk, heel lief.
Ja.
Waar had je deze rotweiler vandaan?
In Brabant.
Ja?
Daar zitten veel kappers.
Ja.
Beekendonk.
Beekendonk. Het was niet een rasfokker of zo, gewoon een hobbyfokker?
Nee, een rasfokker.
Ja? Oké. Okay. Nee. Ik vind het echt heel mooi, ze is mooi atletisch. Kijk naar die taille.
Ja, maar ze is veel afgevallen.
En snel? Ja, maar ze is niet te mager.
Nee, ze is nog een beetje bijgekomen. Ze was na de sterilisatie. Ik heb haar laten steriliseren in september.
Ja.
Toen was op een gegeven moment voor 40 dagen terug 38 kilo.
Ja, dat is flink.
En dat is eigenlijk gek.
En waarom heb je dat laten steriliseren? Je wil gewoon genesje?
Bij Brands in Geleen.
Maar waarom heb je dat gedaan? Wou je genesje?
Nee, ik wil genesje.
Want het is wel echt een mooie atletische rotweiler, hoor.
Ja, maar die andere waren ook zo. De vorige wat ik heb gehad.
Ja?
Ja, op oudere leeftijd niet meer. Hè. Die is 14 geworden. Maar in de jonge jaren was ze ook zo. Was ze 36 kilo. Die was een stukje kleiner.
Ja, maar ze heeft echt hele mooie lengte in de poten. Niet zo enorm groot hoofd. Ja, we hebben altijd iets kleiner hoofd dan je.
Ja, maar dat is een tiefje, nou. Ja, ja. Die zijn altijd...
Ja, dat klopt. Maar ja, echt mooi. Ze lijkt wel een beetje op zo'n, ja, met een massievere borstkast dan, maar zo'n Alano Espanol. Moet je maar eens opzoeken, is ook een hele mooie atletische hond. Alleen deze neus vind ik beter dan de huidige. Mooie neuslengte zit erop.
Ja, het is qua ademhaling.
Ja, beter, zeker. Jij hebt door.
Je hebt zoveel honden wat problemen hebben.
Ja, en dit is gewoon heel goed. Dus ik ben, elke keer geniet ik als ik deze mooie rotweide zie.
Dat is ook super lief.
Ja, dat zie je.
Ja, die andere waren het. Ja, maar...
Oh, dan kan ik niet zeggen, dan komt er de baas, zo'n hond, zo'n baas. Nee, ik maak een grapje.
Ja, die waren meer rotweilen. Ja. Die waren, als je het zei, weet je wel, groot.
Ja. Ja, ja.
En die moesten de baas zijn bij de honden en dan was het goed. Ja.
Ik snap het, ja. Maar dat gaat niet altijd, hè.
Nee, dat gaat niet altijd.
Nee. Ik vond het heel leuk om u te zien. En wens je nog een prachtige dag, maar dat moet wel lukken met dat weer, hè?
Ja, maar we moeten nog werken vandaag. Ja. Vanmiddag.
Oh, ik moet ook werken. Daar moet ik nog even door. Groetje.
Hoi.
Hoi, hoi. Still getting back to the donation. It's quite a different appearance as compared, for example, the Rottweiler that we just saw. But also the Rottweiler has a man-stopping ability. The Dalmatian, if you have a big male dog, perhaps it can work someone to the ground. That's a healthy male human. But I don't think the Dalmatian has a lot of man-stopping ability, which the Rottweiler has. Even that smaller bitch that you saw there. 38 kilograms she was, and now she's getting heavier again because she was sterilized. The other thing about so I mentioned the beer test. Goedemorgen. It gives you insight if your dog has hearing problems or not. But there's also the thing with Dalmatians. It's very funny because all Dalmatians are born white, as you saw in the movie as well. Relative Hill wanted them to for their fur, and at the beginning they all looked white, and she wanted the ermine like fur. So the ermine is a beetle type marten with the black tail and white coats in the winter, and the reddish coats and black tail in the summer. So the white with black has always been seen as a royal type. I think also that means that's the reason that they bred this coloration in dogs was also because of the royal look and appearance of those dogs. You also see them in other breeds, for example, the Harlequin Danish dog, or Great Dane. That's his coloration, also the royal appearance. Furthermore, it's good to notice that the Dalmatian has influenced some other breeds. For example, the English Bull Terrier started his life as the White Cavalier, so the White Knight, and it was an all-white dog with some blackish dots. It was a combination of the Bull and Terrier of that time, so the pit dog of that time, the English White Terrier, which was also white, of course, and the Dalmatian. After a while they also bred in the Borzoi, which is a side hound to get even more Roman nose, but that was never that functional inbreeding or outcross, depends what you want to take out of it. I think they were inbreeding because they selected on that type of nose a lot. So you can inbreed on genes, but you can also inbreed on the characteristics, more the phenotype. So in that dog also you see a Dalmatian. Also the English Bull Terrier was developed as a guarding type of dog for the nobility, the nobleman, and therefore it's not a surprise that they used the Dalmatian for this, because also this type of dog had that characteristics. Whereas the White Terrier was a good ratter and also quite fierce for its size, and the Bull Terrier was just a pit dog, so a good fighter, and they put it all together to get a quite stable defender in being the White Cavalier, also known as the English Bull Terrier. Although there's little bull left as compared to other breeds, for example Staffordshire Bull Terrier, who was more the original type. Another breed that has influences of the Dalmatian is a dog in Australia, the Australian cattle dog. Also these dogs, they are in two colors. One is the more reddish one with a red coat over its white coat. So it's all those dogs start with a white coat, the red and the dark heelers that are known as blue heelers. Because black in combination with white gives that bluish appearance. And also you can have denotations of black that can be either brown or blue. Or even like a red, as you've seen also in some Dalmatians, that they even get the red nose. Also pigmentation of their nose diminishes. But back to the heelers. This is a dog that was also for an all-round cattle dog that could defend the property if needed. I think that was the role of the Dalmatian also, because of the speed. As I mentioned before, the Dalmatian was bred for speed and endurance, which is good. But also has blood of it from all kinds of shepherd breeds, like the ancestors of the Border Collie, that type of dog, combined with a little bit of dingo blood to give it more endurance and heat tolerance, and better for more rugged feet to work all day in Australia. And there was again a Bull Terrier introduced to give it more power to handle obnoxious bulls. So just to give you the full perspective. This dog there looks like a Patterdale, but it's not. Hoi hoi. Hey. Ik vind ze altijd een beetje op elkaar lijken, die twee.
Ja, maar die van deze rotzak.
Ja? Hoe bedoel je een rotzak?
Even snuffen en daarna begint hij...
Begint ze vervelend te doen.
Aan de handen vast te zitten nu.